What I say at this moment now, I'm telling you that my perception might change in the future. What I say at this moment, the doggy in the street, the cat down the road, the doggy, the bed. Everything has its consciousness. Okay, you know, I felt that the five first days of my awakening. Okay. Because that's where the soul expanded like crazy. Imagine this. Suddenly, I was in a very high consciousness level that I couldn't stay there because my whole human body was carrying a lot of garbage. You know, that's what I'm. You know, the spiritual awakening is a process where you remove layers of yourself until you reach to your true self. You know. That's what the spiritual awakening is. You remove layers. You remove all the bullshit. Pew! Until you ascend. It's an experience which you discover yourself. Okay, pretty much or less. And you find your divine essence and your soul. You connect with your soul, with your spirit, with the spirit world, with everything. Okay. It's a destructive process, imagine. You drop everything behind so you can find your true self. So, I felt that especially the first week, not 5 days, the first 7 weeks. I was feeling really highly one with everything, okay? With the trees, with... how do you explain that in words? Not possible enough to explain in words, but... what I see at this moment from where I am is that there is a purpose behind everything, okay? But I can't explain the purpose of it. It's really complex. I'm not in a position to explain, okay? Only God knows. Only the Father knows. I can't explain that, but I see that there is a purpose behind it. They told me that there is a purpose behind it, pretty much or less. Okay, that's what I need to know at this moment. That there is a purpose behind it. Why I'm sure about that is because I can see the purpose behind many things. Okay, I can see the purpose behind many things. Of course, a really small amount, you know, a drop in the ocean of all the universe, but I can see it. And I'm in a position where I can see that everything runs with divine order, okay? Because it has proven in front of my eyes through my life experience. But it's really complex to put in words, bro. The why I say that, you know, the why, because you want an answer, though. You want an answer now that I'm not able to put it into words, you know. I'm not fucking able to put, unfortunately, to give you an answer, you know. Some things are really hard to put in words. It's an experience you have to live, you know. It's much easier to understand. I can't put, unfortunately, because I have to describe my life, you know, and it's really hard to do that in words, and I need hours and hours and hours. Agrees. If only humans could see souls from their eyes instead of bodies, how different the world would be. Yeah, that's so. You know, that will happen in this planet, okay? As we ascend, as all human beings ascend in the fifth dimension, it's happening now, you know? It's happening. This will happen. Maybe not in our lifetimes, but maybe in our lifetimes as well. I don't know. Yeah, that would be awesome. That would be awesome. That's fifth dimension, bro. Everyone would be accepted. you wouldn't be in need of everyone would be accepted and in the position where he belongs, you know. Imagine how beautiful, how what humanity, for example, could achieve if everybody was united, if everybody was wealthy, if everybody was loved. Imagine what human beings could achieve if they were in unity. Imagine what human beings could achieve if they were connected with the higher self. Imagine. That's the paradise on earth that will be, maybe, I'm not sure if it's gonna be in my lifetime. I can't talk about your lifetimes. But I'm not sure it's gonna be in my lifetime. Maybe in the end. Maybe. How our appearance control our life. Okay, I can't lie here, okay? I can't lie here. I can't lie here, you know. I don't prioritize appearance anymore. I prioritize soul, a good soul, a good vibe. If you give me good energy, I prioritize that. But at the same time, I like the good appearance, you know. I'm attracted to the good appearance. But for example, if you have good appearance and your internal shit, I'm not attracted at all, you know, personally. So I believe your appearance, at least your appearance plays a critical role. The more unawake you are, the bigger role it plays in your day-to-day life, your appearance, because you are focused only in your body. You know, your human body, where your human body is the smallest part of your existence, you know, it's a really small set of your existence. That's your human body. So because you are unaware, unawake, it plays a critical role. And because you are unawake, unaware, you are a slave of each other opinion around. You are a slave of their opinions. You need to free yourself from that, okay? Yeah. Mind of what everybody tells you, and you will be a slave of your opinions for the rest of your life. You'll be a slave of them. You need to free. You need to be free. Okay. You need to be free. Free from everything, everybody. Find yourself, love yourself, and then share with them, but share with them love. Share with them consciousness. Share with them depth. Try to help them find their way back to their true self. Καλησπέριγος Γκάνταλφ. Yeah, you see this wear, but this wear here has a lot of layers. It's true. I have this persona, this ego. I used to have this. I don't have it anymore. Now I stream for another purposes. For a purpose like this, for example. I used to have built inside my mind that persona, that ego layer of me being a CSGO streamer, for example, or a Valorant streamer. That, after my awakening, it came a spongy, destroyed that in days through my life, you know. That layer has been destroyed in days, that ego layer. I used to be that streamer, you know. Not anymore, for example. Now I perceive completely different. That's what spiritual awakening does. It comes and it destroys your whole life, you know, so you can move to another levels. That you know, it leaves behind everything that no longer you know, that no longer that holds you back, that it leaves behind everything that holds you back from your evolution, you know. That's what I'm telling you. You have to live this experience. When you the way I perceive, okay, the way I perceive, I'm telling you the way. Through a lot of soul lessons. Okay, you have, for me, where I'm telling to myself, you have to do the things, you have to take the decision that will bring the perfect balance between the emotional balance, between the mind balance, between the health balance and the money balance. Okay, you don't have to be afraid of the money. You don't have to hide money like a lunatic. You have to find the perfect balance between the four. Okay, because if you have the one, you will have nothing. You need to have all four in the highest level. That's success for me. In the highest perfect balance possible. That's success for me, okay? Through perceiving a lot. And that's happiness, actually, not success. Let's be more honest and more correct here. For me. And through a lot of guidance from above, okay? Because you'll realize if you hunt only money, for example, you'll reach up to a point of your life where you will feel completely empty, okay? And that's what Jim Carrey did. And Jim Carrey, you know, he walked his path, you know, he achieved all his goals, he got a lot of money, you know, he had everything he needed, but he reached to a point where he said there was nothing there, you know. Okay. For example. Because there are a lot more things. Thank you, Mew. Me too. Where and how to find a mentor? Okay. In the moment of my awakening, one of the... I don't know, bro, you don't find the mentors. The mentors find you when you are ready. I really highly believe in that. The mentors find you when you are ready. Bro, that's so true in my life. You know, the mentor that plays a massive role in my life at this moment appeared the day of my awakening, bro. He just came. Pew! The teacher will find the student when the student is ready. That's so true. At least in my life. Θα σε βρουν μόνοι τους, μην αγχώνεσαι. Εσύ να κοιτάς να εξελίσσεις. Και να περπατάς τη ζωή σου και να ακολουθείς την καρδιά σου. Follow your heart, walk your life and the mentors will find you. Or your soul will make you find your mentor. It's something similar. I've been looking for a mentor almost 5 years. Maybe I'm me. Hello, Zarathustra. It is really hard to find you someone who really understands you and have the proper knowledge to be your mentor. In my life, the mentors came to me. You know? In my life. Came to me exactly the moment where I mostly needed them. That's my life. It's really hard to find someone who really understands you. Welcome to my life. Yeah, I highly agree with that. And have the proper knowledge to be your mentor. Yeah, I agree with that. It's really hard. But I think it's gonna come in your life when you really need it. At least that how it worked with me. My friend, I sent you an request on Facebook. I want your opinion. Okay, okay, after the stream. Do you believe that people who see and understand all that programming will always be sad thinking about it? And if they didn't know, they would be more happy and ignorant. Okay. The Matrix, the 3D, is all about ignorance. It's all about the ego. It's all about me. That's the 3D consciousness level. Okay. I believe that people who see and understand all that programming at the beginning, they feel really like an outcast. They feel really overwhelmed. Until those people learn how to ground their energy, how not to get affected by the environments, they will get all this negative energy. They will get all this energy, and they will feel overwhelmed as fuck. It's really heavy from the perception of the guy that is outside. It's really until the guy that is outside the box gets in his power. Until he begins to drag people out. This feels like overwhelmed and drawn like set from this. Some say that if someone understands the fourth dimension, they can use the impulse of human being. Do you think it's true? We're going deep here. I believe the more you ascend in dimensions, the more abilities you unlock in your human body. Okay. For example, what I said this moment in my life, I begin to wake up. Okay, I wake up. Okay, my DNA changes, my mind changes, my body changes, my human body changes. Sometimes I see people things that my previous self couldn't see. I hear things that my previous self couldn't see. I can connect the dots the way my previous self couldn't. I lived an experience where my mind, where my subconscious, where I thought I was crazy, where my subconscious were transforming, and this whole part of my brain was I believe the more you are ascending, the more abilities you unlock in this human body. The inner parts of the human being, I can't say I'm completely open to that. Yeah, maybe you could. I can't personally, but maybe from a level you can. Yeah. I don't say it's 100% true because I didn't live it, because I like to share experience I lived, you know, things I lived. But I'm completely open to that, bro. And I really believe in the power of the human mind, bro. I really believe in this power, in the power of the subconscious mind. I really, the more I wake up, you know, I'm really in deep sleep. But the more I'm really in deep sleep. But the more I wake up, the more I see the power of the human mind, bro. And I believe if you wake it up, it can do miracles, bro. Miracles. Like Jesus. Hello, Bill. Why are you always confident with yourself? Or there was a time you lost your confidence for some reason? It's a thing. Oh, fuck. Were you always confident with yourself and there was time? where you lose your confidence and for some reason this affects your life in some way. Paul, that was the dark night of my soul, bro. That's experience. That's an experience where you're getting disconnected completely. Yeah, of course. Of course. That's depression, bro. You know, depression. I've walked that path. I've walked that path of depression. And that's the reason I can get in the shoes of that people, of those people. What I believe about depression, okay? Depression is a moment in your life that yourself got tired of playing a role that he's not really himself. That's depression, bro, and that's a part of your life where you need to take a deep rest. You know, that's depression. Here is where you have to rest and stop playing that role that is not you, you know? That's depression. And I'm not saying it's a hard part of your life, but it's a blessing in disguise. And if you can't see it yet for all the depressed, you will see it later. That's how I see depression. I think you speak Greek, it will be so much better. No, it's better this way, bro, because more can understand. Hello, my friend. Hello, Xavi. Ah, Trofili, we talked a lot. Malaka, we talked a lot. And because I have to go to Athens tomorrow, I need to close early. I mean, I have to close soon, in like 10 minutes max. Because I need to prepare my stuff, because I'm leaving tomorrow morning and I need to have everything ready tonight, you know. And yeah, a lot of we talked about a lot of stuff, and I think I'm gonna close it here because I really gotta go. I really time pressures me, and I'll stream tomorrow from Athens probably not sure though, because everything maybe tomorrow normal time. Thank you guys. That's enough for today. I really enjoy making discussions like that. It's the most important stuff for me at this moment. For my, you know, this is a yin and yang relationship. When I talk and share, and you talk with me and you share with me your perceptions, we both win. That's for sure. And I love to do that, you know. And I love to do that. I really love those discussions, you know. I love doing those. Guys, good night. Love you all. See ya tomorrow, probably. Hopefully. I don't know. I don't know what the fuck is gonna go there. The last time I was there, I lost one finger. It's okay. I don't know. See ya tomorrow, probably. Tomorrow. I think we thought the thing that you said, but... Okay. The last one, madre. Last one, madre. If my current self was speaking to myself 8 years ago, myself 8 years ago would say to this guy, what the fuck are you telling me, psycho, crazy man? That's what my old self would say. Okay, you know, the truth or the message cannot be somebody can't get your message unless he's ready, but you could never underestimate the power of planting a seed. Okay, that's my answer on that. Never underestimate the power of planting a seed. Okay. And I highly believe that it must be your duty to share your truth. to find your truth and share your truth. I highly believe that I need your truth and you need my truth so we can ascend, you know, together. I highly believe in that. That's why I'm telling everybody to share his truth, not the truth they told you. To find yourself and share you. Okay, that's the most, that's what everybody needs in here. And that's how humans are gonna be free. Woo! Woo! Good night.